Hello, hello. My name is Chef Nikhil, and I'm going to start this episode off by wishing everybody that's watching a very happy Thanksgiving. To celebrate this festive season, we at Urban Planner decided to gift ourselves this beautiful space. So go ahead and hit the bell icon right now, just so that you don't miss out on any of our amazing recipes, tips, tricks, and lots of simply good food. I'm planning to whip up a full-on Thanksgiving feast for all of you, starting with a whole roasted cauliflower with Mediterranean flavors, seasoned with harissa and Aleppo chili. So the first thing that we need to do is to prep our cauliflower. We'll just peel off these green bits of this cauliflower, but make sure to keep the root together, because if as we're roasting the cauliflower whole, we want all of the florets to be in place together. Take off any excess right here. You can also go in with your knife and just cut off any of the bits that we don't want. The whole cauliflower together, but it will give us more space for our marinade to seep into the entire cauliflower as well. So as you can see, I'm keeping my knife straight like this and going in to take that core out. So now that our head of cauliflower is perfectly clean and ready to be roasted, it's time to make the marinade. But before we can do that, I'll just place this on my baking tray so that it can get marinated. Alright, so to make this marinade, we're going to be using a lot of Mediterranean flavors. We have our usual suspect of our extra virgin olive oil, some date syrup to add a little of sweetness and that depth of flavor as well, our gorgeous harissa sauce, which has that licorice-y sort of sweetness along with the spice. A few of my favorite seasonings are jeera powder, aka cumin, Aleppo, which is also known as pul biber from Turkey, and our sweet paprika for that spice. And the secret ingredient, in my opinion, is this beautiful Turkish pomegranate molasses as well. Not just for the color, but for that little bit of acidity. Because that's what's missing from these flavors, right? To gain that right balance, we need some fat, we need some sweetness, we need some spice, we need some seasoning, and we need some acidity. So, let's go ahead and make this marinade. Alright, so first things first, fat is flavor. Write that down because you're going to need to remember that. Fat is flavor. So, half a cup of olive oil. This also acts like a little bit of lubrication. It doesn't burn the outside of the cauliflower as the rest of it cooks. So this is one of the most important parts. So that's our olive oil. Then we'll go in with a quarter cup of our date syrup. Look at this gorgeous consistency as well. Like, ooh, that's like honey. Like, ooh, that's gonna give so much depth, because that flavor of the dates itself and the natural sweetness that they bring is gonna be absolutely fantastic. I'm gonna go ahead and add a quarter cup of this molasses as well, because you know it's all going in the same thing, you don't need to wash it out every time. Use a spoon for our harissa. It's really, really delicious, nice and thick. Do a couple nice big spoonfuls of that.
We're gonna go in with some sweet paprika powder. You see this nice little Spanish lady dancing here? That's what I'm gonna be doing once this roasted cauliflower is ready. I'm gonna go in with a few sprigs, few sprinkles. I like spice, and this sweet paprika has both sweetness and spiciness, so it's the perfect combo. A little bit of cumin powder. Am I working fast? Good. Add one of my favorite ingredients, this Aleppo chili. Just make sure that everything is nice and homogenized along with the oil, creating a nice emulsification as well. Man, that looks so good. Now that our sauce is completely on our cauliflower. It just needs one thing. Our OGs. A little bit of pink Himalayan salt on top. Like get everywhere. Go from the sides. Should be good. I'm just going to flip this. Nice crack of black pepper inside. Seal all of that salt and pepper. Okay, our little whole turkey, whole roast cauliflower is now ready to go into the oven. I've been preheating my oven at 200 degrees Celsius, but I'm going to turn it down at 180 degrees because we don't want the outside to burn while the inside doesn't cook. So at 180 degrees for about 10 minutes, I'll be rotating the cauliflower as it bakes as well. I'll be basting it with this marinade throughout its roasting time as well. So 10 minutes at 180, then we'll turn it down a little bit because the crisp outside is going to form in the first 10 minutes, and in the next 20 minutes at 160 degrees Celsius is going to cook all the way through. So let's get this bad boy into the oven. Oh yeah, look at this. Look at this bad boy right now. So I went ahead and turned this as it was cooking. Don't mind, all of this is going to happen because there's that date syrup in there. So it's going to, you know, char up a little bit. But this is exactly what we want. I do have a little bit of toasted almond that I'm going to top this beautiful cauliflower with on my plate. I'm so excited, so I'm just going to take this back, remove it from my tray, let it drip slightly. That looks so, I'm so happy with that. I can't stop smiling right now. Let me take this out of your way, and then we go ahead and finish our cauliflower. Fully. Just going to use a little bit of this marinade and just drizzle some on top. A quick sprinkle of some toasted almond. So these are just some blanched almonds that I toasted nicely and slowly in a pan. And that's it. That's our beautiful main dish for our Thanksgiving feast. I'm just really, really happy looking at it.